we ever needed people who were committed to better relationships is based on the concept that if we treat this world well, it'll take care of all of us.
Always tell yourself this, it's better to give than to receive. And that's the approach I try to take as far as public service. But I'm happy to see all of you here, and I also want all of you to continue to participate in what our goal is, peace throughout the world.
In my estimation, we can re-familiarize ourselves with one another. Community source solutions that are a manifestation of extended family.
It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream. I have a dream. We have also come to this hallowed spot to remind America of the fierce urgency of now.
The choice is ours to do the work, and the work is the practice every single day. This is personal for me. Lili'u was my aunt, was a confidant of the Queen. I have letters from my aunt to the Queen. The good work of faith and spirits and conviction to stand for peace.
Malalo ko'ehiu.
She seemed cheerful in her daily life and tireless in her work, but inside, she was experiencing a terrible emptiness.
This work is far more difficult than I had imagined it would be. How long will my heart suffer?
Mother Teresa.
The most beautiful story of Gandhi touched me from my childhood, that was the Salt March. The 240-mile march continued for 24 days. On April 6, Gandhi broke the Salt Law, and he was arrested with hundreds of thousands of people. Finally, when they realized Gandhi is uniting the whole nation, they had to abolish that law.
John Lai is such a family man. Maybe you only know him as a statesman, as a premier of China and as a politician. Very respected to the elderly. And he actually good cook. We have a dish, it's called the dragon. It's a lion and it's a meatball. That's John Lai's favorite. We are family. You know, there's about 13 people when the new China revolution changed to the new China. There's only 13 leaders.
People, they were taking more than what they need. They're supposed to live and take only what they need, but that didn't happen. We are at the crossroads. Or we can unite spiritually.
I'm traveling mom for a tradition. We have no home, no place, no temple. Everywhere is our temple.
Up in Buna, wherever we have to go there, it's important. It's our family. When you are in peace with yourself, everywhere you find it, home.
Asia is important to America, and America is important to Asia. We need to find a better way. Find a better way than dropping bombs on one another. I'm delighted to be part of this group. We have a young leaders program that will be 20 years old, where we bring young people from around the world to sit in on our foreign policy dialogues to get them interested.
We're just perfectly situated. We have Aloha, which the Queen said she preserved because it would be needed to save the world. I wanted to explain how I moved from the 60s and not understanding.
Several years after China gained its independence, and there was a great move to punish Japan for what it had done, the atrocities of those years. Our friend, Zhou Enlai, said, we're not going to get anywhere with revenge. We are not going to try these people and create more upset and more division that will last through generation and generation. Not going to make those wounds deeper. So that is a statement of the character of China. First of all, incredibly tough. And second, very wise.
So a family of peace is a family for the whole world. It's living that love. And it begins in this culture in the family, this culture of cooperation, this culture of generosity, giving, receiving. Because the children that will come after us will be children that have vision. They'll be creative.
And the real test of peace is lunch. What do we do about it? My chiropractor said, don't break a bone unless you can heal it. Aloha.